The Commodores, and Three Times a Lady, and before that we heard from Lionel Richie. More 70s music coming up in the next hour. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 4 o'clock. This is Nikki Cardwell. The owners of the UK's biggest container port, Felixstowe, say a strike by dockers is part of a national agenda by the unions. Hutchison Ports say they've offered workers a 7% pay rise along with a one-off £500 payment. The Unite Union says its members need wage increases in line with inflation to keep pace with the rising cost of living. One of the dockers on the picket line, Lucky, said he needed more help.
The guys are not happy with what's going on in the country in general. We've just had enough of corporate greed. Companies earning big, big lots of money and they're not sharing anything. With the fuel prices going up and everything, we just need a decent pay rise so we can just see ourselves through.
The Metropolitan Police say that the student nurse, Awami Davies, was not registered as missing on the force's database when she came into contact with their officers. It's emerged that police spoke to her in South London on the 6th of July, the same day her family reported her missing in Essex. The daughter of one of Russia's most prominent ultra-nationalists has been killed in a suspected car bomb attack. Daria Dugina died instantly when the bomb went off while she was travelling on the outskirts of Moscow. Her father, Alexander Dugin, is believed to have influenced President Putin's strategy in Ukraine. Some Russian outlets have blamed Ukraine for the explosion, something Kiev has denied. BBC Russia's Anastasia Gulubeva says these kind of attacks were more common in the past.
Accidents of this sort happened in the 90s, but now to witness, you know, such an explosion just outside Moscow is quite unusual and is shocking to many. Law enforcement do not have any official version on who might be behind this death, but they said that this murder of Daria Dugina is of the contract nature.
Boris Johnson has approved initial funding for the construction of the Sizewell C nuclear reactor in Suffolk. Officials say the money will be spent on development and planning. Final decision on the building of the plant is expected to be made early next year. The Prime Minister of Singapore says the country will end its colonial-era banning of sex between men. But Lee Hsien Loong said he would take steps to defend the institution of marriage as a union between a man and a woman. In the Premier League, Leeds have romped to a 3-0 victory over Chelsea at Elland Road. John Murray was watching as Leeds scored their third goal.
Here's Rodrigo playing it forward to Dan James down the left-hand side. He's in the full-back position. Cross from James, right-footed. Oh, it's bounced in! It's there! Harrison stretched and put it in. Rodrigo with the initial touch. Whether Harrison was offside, there's no flag. It's a third goal for Leeds United. Surely they're on the way to the 3 points against Chelsea.
BBC News, it's 3 minutes past four. BBC Radio. Orna's here now with the traffic and travel news.
Nikki, thank you. Quite a lot of motorway congestion out there now. Lots of routes heading back from the coast or coastal areas, but looking busy on some of these longer routes now. The M8 and westbound near Junction 23 at Ibrox, we had an accident. It was on the exit slip. Those queues have gone, but it's still queuing towards the roadworks section in Glasgow on the M8 from around 25 at Cardonald eastbound. The East Yorkshire M62 looking slow, and it's around Gaul at Junction 36 to 37 at Howden. An accident in one of the lanes. The A1M southbound queues down from the M18 at Junction 38 there near the Doncaster Bypass and Red House, so slow on that southbound side. And the M6 looking heavy in Staffordshire between the services and Keele services. So around Junction 16 at Crewe to Junction 15 at Stoke, it's looking very heavy at the moment. The M1 has reopened near Leicester. Junction 21, that was where we had the barrier repairs after the motorway closure and accident earlier on. Oxfordshire, it's looking better now, but south of Farringdon, the A420 was closed in both directions. Just south of Farringdon. Apparently, they've reopened one of the lanes. The M4 eastbound, Junction 5 at Langley to 4B near the M25. Two lanes are closed. That's because of an accident. And westbound, it's further west between Langley and Slough West, 6 to 7. An accident there where a vehicle overturned and three lanes are still closed. The M3 is looking very heavy near the M25, just ahead of Junction 3. Very slow as well from Eastleigh to Winchester South, 13 to 11. That's heading north. And the M5 is closed because of a lorry on fire at Exeter at Junction 30 right at the end.